guys. Welcome to Math Homework Hotline. I'm your host, Leah Mixon.
And I am also your host, Maggie Mixon. Welcome back. Guys, for tonight, we have a very special topic, but if you notice, we are wearing pink for Pink Out. Not only are we going to talk about that, though, in a few minutes with our special theme of the night, but also our lines are open right now for you to call in with any math homework question that you have. Notice right there at the bottom of your screen, 813-840-7260. You're also going to take us on the go on mhh.mysdhc.org. We are live streaming. If you are here, local Hillsborough County, Spectrum Channel 635, Frontier number 32. By you calling in with a math question, you get yourself in a raffle for a t-shirt. So you wear one of our special yellow t-shirts around town, Do the Math, which is really cool. But then also you can request that you be on the air with us to do one of our questions, or you can tell us one of your questions and we can do it on air on any topic. Remember, that's really important. So call in on any topic, even though our show on air will be on one specific thing that we'll talk about for tonight's topic. All right, with that being said, Leah, what is tonight's topic?
Well, Maggie, tonight's topic is going to be...
solving equations with rational numbers. One step, two step, and multi-step. Solving equations with rational numbers. That is our topic, with our theme tonight being Pink Out. As you guys know, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, so we wanted you to tune in and notice our special ribbon of consideration, you know, for our families out there. Guys, this is a really important topic. Please get tested. Please make sure that you're taking care of your health. And with this pandemic, you know, it's so extra important that you go visit your doctors. So thank you for tuning in and helping us with the awareness. But at the same time, we're here to do the math with you. And we have on the topic that we just talked about a very special challenge question brought to you by Mathnasium. What's that Mathnasium question, though?
Alrighty, guys, Pink Out Edition. Sue made only one mistake on her homework. Describe the mistake she made and solve the equation correctly. Remember to take a picture of this, guys. To solve it, call in with the right answer to win a little prize, and take a picture of it right now or a screenshot so you can be the very first one to call in with the correct answer.
And that question was 3 quantity x minus 7 is equal to 5x minus 11. Notice the work that was done. What was the mistake? Call us in and tell us how to solve it correctly. So you guys, by you calling in, not only do you get to show all the great math that you know, but you also get to be our challenge winner. By that means that Mathnasium will give you a certificate for a free diagnostic assessment at one of their locations. That's really awesome. But then you get all the different merchandise, you know, from them. Last week when that happened and when we had our challenge question, we had Ryan call in, very first one to call in with the answer. He is at Randall Middle in Miss Daniel's class. So congratulations and shout out to Ryan from last week for winning that special prize. We also had lots of winners last week because they were calling in and doing questions on the air with us. So that was really, really cool, neat thing that we got to do. You can be one of those question winners. Beyond that, though, by you calling in and getting some points for your class, you can have a special shout out. For instance, Mann Middle School did it again. They're in a huge winning streak. I know. They are so excited to be on air with us, but also calling in and getting those phone calls. So Mann Middle School, Miss Whitworth was our winning teacher. So shout out to them. And I know they're watching tonight. So really, really exciting times. So I'm going to tell you, next week is October the 30th. Next week is October the 30th. But when we see the show next week, we're going to have a spooky theme. So you could be wearing your costumes right along with us. Okay, so next week, tune in for that. As we're pinking out tonight, next week we'll be in costume. As we are done with all of these, oh my gosh, great news, we are ready to do some math. Are you ready? Get out those notepads, get out those pencils, and let's start working. Leah, you're gonna do the first question, right?
Yep. Alrighty. Awesome. So as Maggie was saying, we are doing solving one-step and two-step equations tonight. So we're gonna start off pretty easy. We're gonna work our way up to those harder questions as well, just so we make sure everyone is doing the math with us. So right up front, we're given y plus 4/5 equals 1 2/5. Now there's a lot of ways you could go about solving this. I'm gonna show you one or two. So what's most important in solving one step or two step equations is to check your work, one, after you get your answer, to do the opposite operation to cancel things out, and to always do the same thing to both sides of the equal sign. So I like to draw a line just to make sure at that equal sign that I'm doing the exact same thing to both. Now, to solve it, you want to get the variable by itself. So that's the whole reason you're going about this. So what can we do to this side to get y by itself in this case? Well, since we're adding 4/5, we can subtract 4/5 from both sides. And in doing that, we come over here. So we have that 1 2/5 minus 4/5. And just to do that fast, let's convert this into an improper fraction. 5 times 1 is 5, plus 2 is 7, giving you 7/5 minus 4/5. Remember when we did operations with fractions a few weeks ago? And we can just do, because these have a like denominator, 7 minus 4 is 3, and then keep that like denominator. And that bring everything down. So we canceled that whole thing out, giving us just the y left. And remember, your equal sign is your line, equals that 3/5. And now, again, as I was saying, most important is to plug that back into your original equation. So let's do 3/5 as your y plus 4/5 equals 1 2/5. And then we can add 3/5 plus 4/5. It's going to give us 7/5 equals 1 2/5. And that is correct. That checks out.
Very nice. We love being able to check our work. I don't know about you guys, but you know when you ever do the math problem and you're like, I wonder if I'm right, or you ask the math teacher, am I right? Or some people are like, oh, I'm done. But maybe you're sitting there with the wrong answer. With these, you could totally check your work. That's what's so exciting about them. All right, so you'll notice on my board that I have a couple of more of these one-step equations. Now, why are they called one-step equations? Well, guys, if you notice, there's a variable, and that letter can be any letter in the alphabet. We try to pick letters that don't look like numbers. For instance, if you do the letter T, sometimes it looks like a plus sign. So depending on how you write the T, the X may look like a multiplication sign, but a lot of times you're going to notice it in your textbooks and whatnot as this little italics, you know, type of X. So that's definitely an X, so a variable. Those letters stand as a placeholder, if you will, for a number. So here it's saying 4 times something is equal to 28. The trick with these is trying to figure out what's going on with the variable, with that letter, and the number next to it. So here, since this is right up against each other, there's no addition sign in between them, so I am not adding. There's no subtraction sign in between them, so I'm not subtracting. I'm not dividing, and dividing can sometimes look like a fraction like that, or the actual division sign. Okay, so I'm not doing any of those. I am multiplying. There's nothing in between them. They're right up against each other, so that's how I know that I'm multiplying. So you say to yourself, 4 is being multiplied by x, and that has to equal 28. Maybe when you were in math class at one point in your life, it had a little multiply sign and a little box, and it said, hey, fill in the box, or fill in what's missing. 4 times what is 28? And a lot of you that know your math facts, you're going to say, well, that's pretty easy. That's 7. 4 times 7 is 28. And I'm going to tell you that is correct, but that's what's called an arithmetic way of doing that. When we're looking at this, we're going to do what's called algebraic, because these one-step equations are going to lead into two-step equations and then multi-step equations. So you have to do what Leah had mentioned, the opposite operation or the inverse. So the opposite of multiply, you know, is divide. So I have my fraction bar divide so that the 4s can cancel each other out. Okay, I'm not dividing by 4x because that would have canceled the x's out. Just dividing by 4, which is called the coefficient of x. If I do that on the left side, I have to do a division by 4 on the right side as well. And that's called balancing your equation, okay? Equation again, because it has an equal sign in between the left side and the right side. So the x is what's on the left side. I brought my equal sign down. And then I say to myself, what's 28 divided by 4? And we knew that from the very beginning that the answer was 7. But now you've shown that algebraically. Again, these are called one-step equations because all I had to do is one thing. I did one step to get my answer. Now, sometimes you're going to multiply or divide, and other times you're going to add and subtract. So for this one, first thing I always do is I look at my variable. There's that p, I'm taking away 83 and I'm gonna get 129. Again, some of you are gonna think, if I just had this in my head, Maggie, what number, take away 83 is equal to 129? And you could do that pretty quick, right? But when you're doing that in your head pretty quick, what you're really doing is you're adding 83 and 129 together, because those are the opposites of each other, right? Subtraction and addition. But again, that's the arithmetic way. So when we do algebraic, we gotta show, and notice how I line up my numbers, okay? I'm not touching the P because the P is on that left side of the equal sign. I'm gonna leave the P alone because I'm gonna solve for that P and put down my line. Now if I were to show it like this, something is missing. So here I have to put that plus 83 on the right side of the equal sign. So if I was subtracting 83, now I'm gonna add 83 to both sides. So the P, since the 83 is canceled, is equal to, and then here I went ahead and I lined up my place values and I say 129 plus 83 is equal to 212. 9 plus, or 3 plus 9 is 12, carry the 1. That would have been 5 plus 1 is 6, and then 1 times 3 is 3. And so forth. What am I doing? I'm not doing that right. I was doing multiplication by multi-digit. Yeah, I'm getting confused with that fifth grade topic right now. I was just doing that when I was explaining you what I was doing a multiply. And you guys, sometimes when you're multitasking in math, you see how it doesn't go so good. So let's try that one more time, Ms. Maggie. All right, so I am adding. How do I know what operation I'm doing? It shows you right there, lady. Yep, exactly. And that's what I want you to do. Always double check yourself. What makes sense? And it's okay as a mathematician to go back and say, that doesn't make any sense. So let's do this again. I am adding. I have lined up my place values. What's 9 plus 3? 12. There's the 2. Carry the 1. 8 plus 2? 10. Add the 1. So that's the 1 down there and then the 11. So 1 plus 1 is 2. So definitely, guys, when you're looking at these and you say to yourself, there's my final answer, you can always plug those in like Leah was showing you to check your work. So if I say 212, take away 83 equals 129, you'll know that that answer checks out. Same thing with the 7. 7 times 4 is 28, and that answer checks out. Beautiful work. One-step equations, because you could solve this in one step and just double-check that your answers are reasonable, that you did the correct operation.
That math looks beautiful, Maggie. I'm gonna do a few questions on the same topic, just a little bit different. So these look a little similar to what she was doing before, but always the same rules. So let's see, we have a W over 9 equals 10. So remember that that little fraction is just a division problem. So really this is W divided by 9 equals 10. And what's the opposite of dividing is multiplying. So you multiply both sides by 9. So let's do both sides by 9. And because that 9 times that is going to cancel out and leave you with just the W, equals 9 times 10 is 90. And then we can check it back out by plugging that 90 back in for the W. So if we had 90 over 9, or 90 divided by 9, that would indeed equal 10, making it check out.
Very nice. And we talked about we can always check ourselves with these.
For sure. And looking at the exact same idea over here, we have a negative h equals 14. Now when you see a negative in front of a variable, you have to pretend there's a little 1 there. So pretend there's a negative 1h. So that means you divide both sides by that negative 1. So divide by negative 1 on both sides. Negative 1h divided by negative 1, not negative 1h. Because that would cancel the h out too. It's gonna cancel those out, leaving you with just the h variable, equals 14 divided by negative 1, which is gonna be negative 14. You can plug that back in. So we have a negative 14 equals 14. And remember that two negatives make a positive, so it makes it a big old positive 14, and that cancels out.
Very nice. Sounds like we have a challenge question winner already, though.
Alrighty.
Whoa! Very exciting.
Is that Araceli?
Hey, Araceli.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good.
All right, who do you want to do the challenge question with? You get to pick either Maggie or Leah.
Leah.
All right. So all Leah right, gets Araceli. To do the question with you. So she's going to be working, getting her board ready, and let's remind our audience, today's challenge was to look at somebody's work that was already, completed, figure out the mistake, and then to correct that mistake. So what'd you come up with?
So
how do you like to solve these problems?
So what I did first is, in the parentheses, I did 3x and then I multiplied 7 by 3.
Mm-hmm. I remember that's a negative 7 since there's a negative in front of that.
Negative 21.
Mm-hmm. All right, perfect. And what was the mistake that Sue had made? Instead of getting this as her answer, she had 3x minus 7 equals 5x minus 11. She had forgot to distribute that 3 to the 7 as well. So that made her whole answer wrong. But let's continue to solve this to see what her answer should have been.
And then I subtracted 3x.
Mm-hmm. From both sides?
Yeah, I subtracted it on both sides.
What did that give you?
And that gave me negative 21.
Negative 21. Equals.
And then.
Yeah.
It equals 2x.
Yeah.
And then I added 11 on both sides.
Perfect. Remember to bring
and
down.
Then,
yep.
And then it's negative 10. And on the other side, it's 2x.
Mm-hmm. And then what's your final step?
Divide.
By.
And you get negative 5.
Yep, divide by 2 on both sides to cancel it out in front of that x. Negative 10 divided by 2 is going to be 5 equals x, which is your final answer. You could plug it back in if you wanted to.
Is it positive 5 or negative?
Or negative 5.
There you go.
Sorry about that. Whereas Sue had gotten what as her answer?
I got negative 5.
Yep, negative 5 is the correct answer, whereas Sue's mistake was 2. So because you didn't do that, or you did it correctly, but because Sue didn't distribute correctly that first line, her whole question was wrong. Guys, you really need to make sure to hit every single one of your math rules, follow each step thoroughly. Thank you so much, Araceli, for calling in and helping me solve this with the right answer and the right work.
And Araceli is calling from Shields, so shout out to Shields, and you're gonna get that special Mathnasium prize. Congratulations, Araceli. Woo! All right, so Leah did a lot of work with Araceli. They did not one step, not two step, but those multi-step equations, so they went right to that. But you're gonna see here that I'm gonna continue taking you through the different levels, so like that it doesn't become whoa, in your face type of thing, that you get all of that at once. But notice that we are bringing a number of skills together here, guys. With this one, if you notice, again, 2x plus 13 equals 35. We keep trying to say to ourselves, what is x going to have to equal? X is going to equal one specific number, and how do we find that number? If you're going to sit there and do what's called trial and error, and you just keep plugging numbers in for the x and trying to see if it works, you'd have to be thinking to yourself, what multiplies times 2, then when I add 13, I'm going to get 35. So we think of that in reverse, okay? So what you do first is you're trying to do what's called isolate the variable. So you identify, where's that variable? Where's that letter? I went ahead and I circled it because that becomes a little bit easier for some people to see. We can't touch that term yet until we get rid of the 13, okay? So this is kind of like its own little cabin, if you will, its own little section, because we want to get rid of what's around it, throw it all onto the other side of the equal sign. You'll see how we do that in a second before you can touch whatever is around that x, all right? So here, if I'm saying I'm adding 13, remember, inverse operations are that opposite. I'm going to go ahead and subtract 13 from both sides. And this is where we were before when we said one-step equations. I'm bringing everything down, and here's that arithmetic. This one was just to cancel, but what I subtract on the left, I have to subtract on the right. 5 take away 3, 3 take away 1, all right? So that was one step. My very first step was to take away 13, but I'm not done yet, right? I still had to realize, what do I do with this 2 to get the x all by itself or isolate that variable. So if you're thinking to yourself, again, this is a multiplication step. The opposite of multiply is divide. I have to do it to both sides of the equal sign. That's what's going to give you that x isolated. It's all by itself now. So 22 divided by 2, the answer is 11. Now, we keep saying that you can check your answer with these, and I would highly advocate for that, especially when you're looking at, you know, some high-stakes testing. So you just say to yourself, if this was the original problem, the original equation, and I'm saying that the answer for x is 11, I just plug in where I see that letter, the number that I'm proposing as the answer. So 2 times 11 is 22. Add 13, and does that equal 35? Well, again, here's the 22 plus 13. Looking at your place value, 2 plus 3, that's the 5. The 2 plus the 1 is the 3, so it checks out that 35 is equal to 35. So you know then that x, that mystery number, if you will, was definitely 11. So these are what's called two-step equations, because now you did two steps to be able to get the final answer. Or what was it that x was equal to? So this is called rational numbers, or operations with rational numbers can involve negatives, can involve fractions. But now solving those equations, you got to remember all of those great rules that happens with fraction and negative numbers. All right, Leah, back to you.
All right, Maggie, I have here on my board some more practice with those two-step equations just to make sure that you really get them. This is a really important topic that will be built upon for the rest of your math career. So we have m over 7 minus 4 equals 3. So what should we tackle first? So I think in this situation, we need to deal with that 4 first. Again, I don't know if Maggie went over that, but you should kind of do opposite PEMDAS in a sense. So you should start with your addition and subtraction. So let's move that 4. Because it is subtracting in this equation, we want to add it to both sides to cancel it out. So we have that negative 4 plus 4 to cancel out. And then 3 plus 4 is 7. And then we have to bring down everything else that we didn't touch yet. So we have m over 7 equals 7. So that was our first step. Our second step is now to get that fraction down to just the m. So because remember that's a division sign, also like remember fractions are just division problems, let's do multiplying instead. Multiply by 7 to cancel it out. We're dealing with a lot of 7s tonight in this problem. So multiply both sides by 7 to cancel that side out and give us m equals 7 times 7, which is 49, which is our answer. And now that was our second step. We can plug that 49 back into the original problem to make sure that we're doing it correctly. Let me grab a different color here for you guys. So let's plug in 49 for m. 49 over 7 minus 4 equals 3. So 49 divided by 7 is going to be that 7 again. 7 minus 4 equals 3. And that is correct, and it checks out.
Woohoo! So lots of different skills here, Leah.
For sure.
So you guys, when we're looking at integers, remember that's positive and negative numbers. We're dealing with letters. So I know people say, and I have kidded about this on the air before, but people will say, I was so great at math until they threw the alphabet in there, right? Well, when you get to a certain level of math, you will have those letters in the place of those numbers. Here you'll notice that I have the same exact problem on the left and the right. And what I did is I put one as a solve and one as a check. Like even from the very beginning, I know I'm going to check my work because these are so important that I get it right. And guys, you could be so like on it and you're like, oh yeah, I'm doing so great with every single one of these steps. And then something just happens that maybe you multiplied instead of add, or you added instead of multiply, or whatever the operation was. And you were so confident, but then once you check it, if you see that it doesn't have give you the right answer, then you go back and do that error analysis. Kind of like what Araceli did today with the question that was on the challenge question. All right, so give you just a second. This is the problem. Again, it's still gonna be a two-step equation. Here's the P. I multiplied by 5, I took away 8, and that gave me 42. So we're going to do this in reverse. All right, so I'm going to add 8. This is called your constant. So that you get 5P is equal to, these 8s cancel out. What's 42 plus 8? You got it, 50. All right, now again, I divide both sides by 5. And those 5 cancels out. So I got the answer. Again, I'm proposing that the answer is 10. This was done in one step, two steps, and now I'm going to take that 10 and I'm going to plug it right back into that letter P to double check. Now you may think that this is a lot of work, and some people are like, I don't want to take the time to see that, but just think about it. Just a few seconds more and you'll make sure that for sure that that is the answer that should be in the place of the letter that you're looking for, the letter P in this case. So I plugged in the 10 into the place of that letter or that variable. I follow my order of operations. So I have a multiply and then a subtract. So 5 times 10, take away 8. And I'm checking to see if that's going to equal 42. Again, 50 take away 8, the answer checks out. Very nice. And again, you can be so confident that you're doing it correctly, but when we start throwing in negatives or we start throwing in fractions or decimals, sometimes it gets a little bit more challenging on this side for the thinking, and that's why it's nice to be able to check yourself. All right, so with that being said, we have some prize winners. Some of you have been calling in and getting your questions answered with our teachers on the phone. So we have Caitlin from Rogers getting a prize tonight, Adriel from Maniscalco, and Dakota from Mann. So congratulations, you'll be getting those t-shirts in school mail.
Alrighty, Maggie, moving right along on this same kind of topic, but now we're looking at a word problem. Ooh, word problems can be scary, but remember, just stick to your math rules and they're not so bad after all. So we are given 8 more than twice a number is 8. And they want us to write an equation for the statement as well as solve the problem and check the solution. So we have 3 things to do here, and let's get into it. Now, for questions like these, you really have to remember your math terminology. So 8 more meaning addition, then twice a number. Twice is going to be multiplying, and multiplying by 2 at that. So multiply by 2, a number is 8. So we have 8 more, so 8 plus twice a number, that number we didn't know. And as Maggie said earlier in the show, when you don't know a number, you represent it with a variable. I'll use x in this situation, is 8. That means equals 8. So that is how we're going to write the equation for that. We have 8 plus 2x equals 8 is the numeral representation of that. Now to solve it, what are we going to do? So as we've been doing, we start with the number that is not with the variable. So we're going to start with that 8 over here. And because it's a positive 8, we're going to subtract 8 on both sides. So subtract 8 on both sides, and that makes it cancel out. But oh no, it cancels out on this side too. So that means it's going to be 0. So 2x equals 0. 8 minus 8 is 0 over here. And 2x equals 0. Remember, you still got to solve. Divide both sides by 2. X equals, and 0 divided by 2 is 0. So x equals 0. Let's plug that back in. If you plug 0 in for 2, it's going to give us 0 here. And then 8 plus 0 equals 8, which is correct.
Very nice. Those sounds like little math word problems.
Yeah.
Or like math puzzles, if you will. Number puzzles, which can be really fun, guys. Have you ever gotten those questions like, Sue is 3 times Jen's age, and in a few years, in 5 years, they're going to be, I don't know, a third of each other's age or something crazy like that? Use that math. Use those algebraic skills that you got so like that you can know how to solve those types of questions. What we're showing tonight, though, are the skills to be able to do that algebra. All right, so here we go. Solve and check again. Still a two-step equation, but notice something a little bit different. Before, we ended up representing the letter as the first term. Remember that that is not a rule. The letter can appear anywhere in that equation. It could be as part of the first term, part of the second term, part of the right side of the equal sign, and you'll see some of those when we start doing multi-step equations. But I wanted to show you something like this because, again, it looks like a fraction. There are some negatives, so it's increasing that thinking a little bit more. Let's tackle it. There's our variable. We're not going to touch that term yet. We're going to get rid of what's around it. So what's around it is that negative 2. Now, this shows an addition sign. But if I have negative 2, the only way to cancel a negative 2 is to add 2. So you think of what's the opposite. So a negative 2 and a positive 2 are the only way to cancel that negative 2. If I would have put here a negative 2, this was not going to cancel to 0. It was going to give me actually a negative 4. So if I have 2 negatives and I have two more negatives, it was going to give me negative 4. So the only way to cancel a negative 2 would have been to add two positives. So with that being said, I just wanted to show you, because sometimes, again, it can be a little bit like, what do I do first? How do I get rid of that constant? Remember, the number that doesn't have a letter associated with it, that's your constant, okay? So add 2 to both sides of that equal sign. This entire term goes down. So it still looks like y over 10. These did indeed cancel. Bring down my equal sign. I have 6 negatives, and I'm adding 2. So I'm down 6, and I gain 2. So what do I have? Well, I'm now only down 4. If you needed to represent this in symbols, guys, because, again, integers can be a little bit tricky for some people, I would say to you, think of that 6 as 6 negatives. Now you added 2, so you have 2 that are positive. These guys canceled out. Those are called zero pairs. So then you have 4 negatives left. And if you need to do that a little bit to kind of help you remember these, it'll transition you into then not having to draw those as much anymore. All right, so then we have, again, that was my first step. I'm getting ready to do my second step. But this is a little bit where people get all confused, because they say, well, what's happening with this y, Maggie? What's going on with that variable? Well, you could only have one of 4 operations. Is it an addition, a subtraction, a multiplication, or a division? Well, it doesn't have an addition sign in between them, so that's not that. Doesn't subtract, it doesn't have a subtraction sign in between them. There's no multiply sign in between them, so it has to be that division. All right, so those operations, making sure that we know how they're going to be represented. Here, y is being divided by 10. So when we divide by 10, the inverse operation is multiply by 10. I'm going to multiply by 10 over 1. So you can see very clearly that those are going to cancel out. So if I multiply by 10 on the left, I have to multiply by 10 on the right. Squeeze that in there. The right side is going to look like negative 4 times 10, and that's negative 40. So I am proposing that y is negative 40. So I'm going to plug that in over here, do that real quick, show you that it does not take very long. Just keep track of those negatives for yourself to make sure that everything is going good. All right, so order of operations, I have to do this division first. Negative 40 divided by 10, that's negative 4. Now, notice that here, I would have had an addition sign and a negative 4. So I'm asking, what is negative 2 plus a negative 4? I could have also just left it as negative 2 minus 4. And either way, the answer is negative 6, which checks out. All right, so congratulations. You're getting the hang of these with us. That was your one-step and two-step equations.
And I do believe we have a caller. Is that Ikenna on the phone? Hi.
Hello.
Hey, you have a problem to work out with us on air?
Yes, ma'am.
All righty. If you could read the problem for me, please, so I can solve it with you.
Oh, I thought we were supposed to, like, which problem is it?
Yeah, I can do a problem. Did you have one that you wanted me to do, or you want me to give you one that we can solve together?
Can I give you one?
Yeah, of course. So I have one just like we were doing before. So we have 7 decreased by 3 times a number is 40. And what it wants us to do is write an equation for that, as well as solve it and check our answer.
So, 7 decreased by 3 times
a number.
A number.
Is 40. So, it wants us to first write the equation for that. So, what can we write?
So, maybe versus the subtract
7
by 3 to get 4.
So we have the subtract by 3. So we do want that decrease by 3 times a number. So that's going to be the 3x there.
Okay. And yeah, I see.
And what should go in front of it?
So we should subtract 7 minus 3 times 10, which should give us 40.
All right, so equals 40. It sounds like you're already solving it for us, Miss Ikenna. Is it Ikenna?
Ikenna.
Okay, Ikenna. That's awesome.
All right, so this is where we're at now. We decided because it was decreased, that meant subtraction. by 3 mm-hmm. times a number. So we have 3 times that number. And this is our equation where we're at. And how are we going to solve that?
So we should take 7 and 3. Mm-hmm. And so subtract 7 by 3.
So not quite, because remember that has the x attached to it. So these aren't like terms. We can't quite combine them. We need to move the 7 to the other side of the equal sign.
Oh, all right.
So how do you do that?
So we're trying to move the 7 to the other side?
Yep.
You got it.
So how are we going to do that?
Let's see.
So because it's a positive 7, we can subtract it, right?
Yes.
So by subtracting 7 on both sides, what is that going to give us? We got to bring down what?
We have to bring down the 3.
Yep, that negative 3x. Perfect. And then what is 40 minus 7?
Excuse me.
40 minus 7?
Yep.
33.
It's 33. Perfect. So we've done that first step. We've gotten it down to negative 3x equals 33. And how are we going to get x by itself to solve that equation?
We're going to have to divide.
Exactly. Divide by what?
By 7.
By the negative 3 that's in front of that x, remember?
Oh, sorry. So yeah. We're going to have to divide it by 3.
Yeah, you're okay. We got rid of that 7.
So that negative 3 is going to be what we divide by. Beautiful.
Right. So that cancels out because of those two negative 3s. Then we have positive 33 divided by negative 33 is going to give, or negative 3, I'm sorry, will give us what?
So positive 33 divided by negative 3?
Yep. Yep. You got it.
I haven't really learned to subtract negative 3, so I'll try my hardest.
Yeah, you're good. Alrighty.
I'm not sure about this one.
That's okay.
33 minus negative 3.
Yeah, so the 33 divided by negative 3, remember, a positive divided by a negative is going to be a negative number. And then 33 divided by 3 is going to be 11.
11. All right.
Negative 11 is our answer.
Negative 11?
Mm-hmm.
All right, that makes more sense.
Yep, and how are we going to check that?
We could time negative 11.
Mm-hmm.
Time 33.
So that gave you negative 11 times negative 3 was 33.
So yeah.
7 plus
times
33.
By 3 times 3.
And then you
also 33.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to have to times that. Mm-hmm. What times 3 is 3? 3 times 5 is 3. What times 3 is 3? So,
all right. All right, so then you just added the extra 7
mm-hmm.
to get your
answer
of 40. You got it. I'm going to tell you, it sounds like if I saw the call correctly, you're a sixth grader, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
That is awesome work for being in sixth grade. I'm going to tell you, that is great thinking. Because that dealt with a lot of concepts that maybe you haven't been working on in class yet. So that is wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Shout out to you and your class. And at Williams. You're welcome, honey. Talk soon.
Thank you so much for calling in.
Bye-bye. Now, I think we do have another caller. Is this Taylor? Hey, Taylor.
Hi.
All right, you ready to do one of the questions with us?
Yes.
All right, I'm going to take my paper off here. You caught me with my notes on my board. Now, if you happen to be looking on the TV, some people have it on air and some people don't. But I have a equation that I bumped up the heat on you. I have a 3 parentheses 2x plus 4 is equal to 60. So what are we going to do first? Now, there's a couple of different things we could do, by the way. And depending on the comfort level, I see that you're an eighth grader.
Yes.
All right. So what would you do first with something like this? You have a little bit more sophisticated math, probably.
Yes. So you're going to do the parentheses.
All right. So how are we going to do that?
We're going to do 3 times 2x, which equals 6x.
Beautiful. And then?
And then you do 3 times 4, which equals 12.
Awesome distribution. I'm going to bring everything else down. So this is what's called multi-step equations, because you had to distribute that 3 first, and now it's going to be a two-stepper. All right, what do you do next?
Then you have to get x by itself, so you're going to do minus 12 on both sides.
You are making me want to cry. This is so beautiful. All right, cancel those 12s equals, what's 60 take away 12, honey?
60 take away 12 would be 56. 58.
All right, so you told me 58. I don't necessarily agree with that because I was thinking to myself.
Oh, wait, you said 60?
Yeah, 60. I think you heard me say 50, but it's 60. So look what I did, though.
60 minus 12 would be 48.
Exactly. I wrote down what you told me at first, and then I was going to say, let's see if that sounds reasonable. Because sometimes you do have to go back and check yourself, right? So you're like, okay, well, that doesn't make any sense. So let's make it a 48. And you misheard me. Not a big deal. Sometimes with the on-air calls, you may not hear exactly what I'm saying. Same with us, where sometimes it's like, what did she say? So now we have 6x is equal to 48. We're almost all the way to solving that problem. What do you do next?
Then you do 48 divided by 6.
Very nice. I'm going to put the 6 also underneath the 6x to show that balance, that algebraic piece. All right, so now 48 divided by 6. Bring it home.
8.
You got it! Ding, 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 ding! Yay! Look at you! So now I go back and I say to myself, if I were to put the 8 in the place of the original x, 8 times 2 is 16.
16.
Add 4.
Add 4, 20.
20. And then that 20 times 3 would have been
60.
60. So we know that that checks out! Listen, you're going to get a special t-shirt from us. Thank you for doing that math with us. That was awesome. Talk soon. All right, you guys, I believe we have yet another call on the air.
Is that Rowan? Hello?
Hello?
Hey, Rowan.
Hello?
Hi, I see that you are from Barrington and you're in eighth grade, so you have a little bit of a higher level math question for us, correct? Did you want to work out one that I have for you, or did you want to bring in your own question?
You can ask me a question.
Okay, yeah.
I saw that you had asked one of our teachers about f of 8.
I know, so I was like, we can do some functions.
I was really excited about functions.
Alrighty, Ron, since you are in 8th grade, I do believe we can get into multi-step equations with you. Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine.
All right.
Alrighty. So we have 3x plus 5 equals 5 times the quantity of x minus 3. Did you get all that?
Say that again?
Yep, so we have 3x plus 5 is equal to 5 times parentheses x minus 3, or the quantity of x minus 3. All right.
Okay.
What's our first step?
We find the x in the -3/5.
Very nice. Yes. To distribute.
So you want to distribute that 5 in there. Perfect. And what's that going to give us?
That's going to give 5x and -15.
And -15. Beautiful. I love how you took care of that negative. And then we bring everything else down. And what's our next step at this point?
Ooh, I see x's on both sides.
So what are you going to do?
I think I would subtract one from the other.
Yep. Very nice.
So honestly, it doesn't really matter which x you pick. As long as you follow your math rules, it'll get down to the right answer. But I'm going to subtract the 3x just so you don't have to deal with negatives right now. So subtracting 3x from both sides, it'll cancel it out on one side. leaving us 5 on that one side of the equal sign, is equal to 5x minus 3x, which is what?
Which is 2x.
Very nice.
5x minus 3x is 2x.
Very nice.
And then bring down that 15. All right, what do you do after that?
You would then subtract the 5 from itself, and then you would add the subtraction to the negative 15, which would make a negative 10.
All right, that's one way you could do it for sure, but just because we have some people in younger math grades on here, we're going to do adding 15 to both sides so that we can solve it the way that they know how at this point. Alrighty.
Okay, that's fine.
So adding 5 and 15 is going to give you 20 on one side. It cancels out on the other, equals 2x. And then what's your last step?
20 on one side. And then you would divide 2 on both sides.
Divide by what?
2. You would divide 2 on both sides.
Beautiful.
Very nice.
And then that leaves you with x equals 10. And then you can check that by plugging 10 back in for x everywhere in the equation. But that's going to be a while. You can do it in your head.
How do you feel about that question?
Huh?
How did you feel about answering that question? You feel confident?
Yeah, I feel very confident.
That's awesome. Leah was showing you that when you had moved the 5 over to the right, it was easier actually to move the 15 over to the left, just because like that you didn't have to deal with it equal to 0, and then you would have had to do an extra step to try to get rid of that number. So I'm just saying, remember how in math there's so many different ways of doing the same thing? That is the beauty of mathematics. It's more than one way to skin a cat is usually what we would say in class, right? All right, so thank you. Congratulations. You are doing that math and in an awesome way.
Thank you.
Thank you. Talk soon.
Have a great rest of your night.
Guys, she did not one, not two, but 4 steps in that problem. So remember talking about that order, and it's very linear as far as matching all your different like terms, keeping track of those negatives, distribution, all sorts of beautiful math. Notice that they had 2 X's in their last problem, and I'm going to show you the same thing here in my board. We're going to have X's on the left, X's on the right, and oh boy, sometimes they can get a little bit like, what do I do first? Before, we were telling you with one-step and two-step equations, it's better to deal with those constants first and get all the constants on one side of the equal sign. Here, I'm going to tell you, since you have X's on both sides of the equal sign, go ahead and do what's called combining of those like terms first with those variables. All right, here's a 10x, here's a negative 2x. In order for you not to deal with negatives, take always the smaller one and bring it to the side where the bigger one is. All right, so here if I have a negative 2x, what's the opposite? Well, I'm going to add 2x. And look again, I'm lining up all my terms. Those x's go together. The ones that don't have any x's, they're all left alone for right now. We're going to leave them be because we don't need to touch those. These canceled. I have a negative 69, a negative 9. All that just simply came on down. Here, 10 x's and 2 x's, when I add them together, I have 12x. And now that became, again, a two-step equation. So I just usually have to do one thing that, you know, what is the thing to do is usually, how do I get started is where sometimes it gets a little bit tricky. All right, so then again here, what we've been showing you throughout the evening, you add 9 to both sides so you could get rid of those constants now. So 12x's is equal to, if I have a negative 69 and I add 9, so I went to the left 69 spots, but now I'm going to go to the right 9, you're going to be left with a negative 60. All right, now you could do this, bring it home, divide by 12, keep track of those negatives, there's that negative, there's that positive. So if I have negative 60, and I divide that into 12 different groups, how much is going to be in each group? So that's what that is when you're saying divide. So 60 divided by 12 is definitely 5, but one's a negative and one's a positive, so it ends up being a negative 5. So if I owe you $60, but I had divided that into 12 different people, or I owe 60, but I've divided that by 12 people, I owe each person $5, okay? So again, to check these, you would plug in that negative 5 into both places, And then you would solve that expression on the left, or I should say simplify, because you're not really solving. You would simplify the equation on the left, simplify the equation on the right, and if they're equal to each other, then you know that that checks out. Now, we keep talking about that, so let's just make sure that we do it at least one time. That 10 times negative 5 minus 9, is that going to equal the same thing as negative 2 times negative 5 minus 69? So let's do that real quick. 10 times negative 5 is negative 50 minus 9. So think about negative 50 minus 9, that's negative 59. Over here, negative 2 times negative 5 is positive 10. Take away 69, it's going to be a negative 59. So they're both equal to each other. We know that for sure. This checks out. All right, Leah, I see that we have some more prize winners, some t-shirt winners.
Do we?
We do. So who are they?
That's going to be Sarasha from, is that Turner Bartels K-8.
Very nice.
We have Jasmine from Burnett and Ricardo from Blake High School.
Woo-hoo!
Guys, go Yellow Jackets, Blake.
Very nice. Mathnasium is still our sponsor, so super excited that they're on board with us and you guys for winning those prizes by not only by calling in, but then also by doing the math with us here on air. Notice the Mathnasium poster on your screen. So Mathnasium proudly sponsors our challenge question, which is really cool. And this evening we had a challenge question from the very beginning.
We did.
And
from the very
I'm
going
to tell you.
Beginning.
Those of you who are calling in and you're saying, that's me. I'm going to be that person who calls in first with that answer. You guys, we're so proud of you. All right, so we were doing one-step equations, two-step equations, multi-step equations, and again, with rational numbers, meaning with fractions, with negatives. And Leah has another question for you that is going to involve multi-steps.
All right, guys, this is another long one. Let's just knock it out. Make sure we really drove those skills home. So we have 5 times the quantity of x minus 1 equals 20 times the quantity of x minus 10. Again, now we're going to distribute each number on both sides, simplify it all, and get it down and follow those math rules. Let's start on the left side, distribute the 5 to the x and to the negative 1. 5 times x is 5x. 5 times negative 1 is negative 5 equals, and now let's distribute that 20. So we have 20 times x is 20x. And then 20 times negative 10 is negative 200. A little bit of a bigger number there. And now let's keep going. We're at this step now, and we need to start moving things. Now, seeing here, I think we can subtract and move that 5x to the other side to keep it in positive numbers. Again, you could choose to subtract 20x from the other side, but then you'd get a negative 15. And if you don't really want to deal with negatives, you can just stay in those positive numbers for now. So let's cancel that out. We had a 5x, get rid of the 5x, and then bring down the negative 5 that was with it. Nothing happened to that number. And then 20x minus 5x is going to be a positive 15x minus 200. At this point, guys, we want to move that to the other side, get that x by itself so we can solve. So let's add 200 to both sides. And negative 5 plus 200, I believe, is 195. I'm sorry. Again, guys, remember you got to do the opposite operation. Because that was a negative 200, you want to add 200 instead. Just like because this was a positive 5x, you want to subtract the 5x to cancel it out. So we had that 195 equals 15x. And then our last step is divide by 15 on both sides. Because you want to get that x by itself to solve. So we had x and then 195 divided by 15.
13.
And 13 is your answer. And to check that, you would just plug 13 in everywhere you see x in the equation. So you plug 13 in here and 13 in here. We can do it in our heads really quick. 13 minus 1 is 12. 12 times 5 is 60 equals 13 minus 10 is 3. 3 times 20 is 60 as well, making that check out.
Woo, woo, woo! And I'm going to tell you that it's some good math. Now we're up to the part where you've done your challenge question. You've been calling in. I honestly think you're up for the next challenge. And this is going to probably end our show. But I'm going to tell you, I want you to really pay attention to this. I have a dice. And I don't know yet what kind of question I'm going to come up with, but maybe some of you have been watching and you're thinking, what happens if I have x's on the same side of the equal sign? So we showed you x's that were just on one side. Then we showed you x's that were on both sides of the equal sign. Now, what happens if it was x's on all on the left, but more than one of them? So let's say that I have four x's, okay? And then I'm going to have add 5. I'm going to keep everything with positive numbers for right now. Then I have another 1x. Oh my gosh, Leah, how many terms are we going to put in here?
Let's go for a 5.
It says another 4x. Oh my goodness gracious. Actually, so this is term 1, 2, 3, 4. You want me to put 5 terms?
5 whole
go
terms.
Go crazy on me. All right, and then, hey, I seem to be rolling a lot of 4s today. So there's another constant, okay? Now, that's all on the left side. Now, on the right side of the equal sign, oh my gosh, just a few more minutes left, I'm going to have 5x's, and I'm going to do a constant plus 6, okay? I told you I was going to try to keep it as simple as possible, whole numbers. But when you have something like this, guys, that is a string of terms, you have to work within that side first, simplify it down, and then be able to start moving things from the left side and the right side of the equal sign. Okay, so you say to yourself, there's a 4x, there's a 1x, there's another 4x. Those are the only terms that have x's. Those are what are called like terms. So a 4 plus a 1, that's an invisible one sitting there. 4 plus 1 is 5, plus another 4 is how many? 9x's. So I'm kind of like cleaning up a little bit, right? Before I can start moving things around the equal sign. The 5 was a positive 5, and that was a constant. The 4 was a positive, and that was a constant. So those are like terms. So now if you notice, that long string, everything on that left, got simplified or reduced to 9x's plus 9. So you have to clean up first your equation before you can then start rearranging it from the left side and the right side. So I just wanted to make that and point that out. Let's finish this up. So I have 5x's, 9x's, that's my next line of defense, if you will. Again, I'm going to subtract the smaller one from both sides so I don't have to deal with negative numbers. 4x plus 9 is equal to 6. I did not have this equation prearranged for you because, again, we were just rolling for our numbers. And let's see how it's going to turn out. I have 4x. These 9s cancel out. Now, what's 6 take away 9? I have 6 candy bars. I take 9 of them away. Well, that's impossible unless I owe you 3. Now here, it doesn't look so pretty because it's not going to give us an even number, or a whole number, if you will. So the last step is to divide by 4. So when I divide by 4, and I do that on both sides, it's going to give me that x is equal to negative 3/4. Yes, indeed, I can leave it that way. So negative 3 divided by 4, if you were to say, well, I need to divide. Well, you just did. It's negative 3/4 because it's going to be same thing as negative 0.75, it's going to give you a decimal value. All right, so I know that we are running out of time, but I wanted to show you that because in case you were wondering, well, what happens if I have multiple x's and they don't happen to be on both sides of the equal sign? What do I do? All right, that's our show. We were pink out tonight, and I'm going to tell you guys again, we're so proud of everything you're doing. Leah, what are your parting words for our crew?
Well, thank you guys so much for calling in, and make sure to write us in your schedule for next week. We'll see you guys soon.